the greater trochanter. Anterior surface provides insertion for smallest gluteal muscle, the gluteus minimus, coming from the gluteal surface of hip bone between the inferior and anterior gluteal lines. On the oblique ridge is inserted the medium-sized gluteal muscle, the gluteus medius, reaching here from gluteal surface of hip bone between the anterior and posterior gluteal lines. Both these muscles have origin and insertion close to each other. These muscles, acting from their insertion, pull the ipsilateral hip bone down so that the opposite hip bone is raised for the foot to be stepped forwards. Thus, these two muscles do a great job in walking. On the inner aspect of the true pelvis is a membrane, the obturator membrane. Arising from the obturator membrane and the area around it is the muscle, obturator internus muscle. It leaves the pelvis through the lesser sciatic foramen. Accompanying it and acting as its bodyguard are superior and inferior gemellus muscles, which arise from the two ends of the lesser sciatic notch. Gemellus means twin. These three muscles are inserted into the medial surface of greater trochanter of femur. Deep in the trochanteric fossa is inserted the obturator externus, which arises from the outer aspect of obturator membrane and the conjoint ischiopubic rami. Piriformis, from middle three pieces of sacrum, runs out of the pelvis through the greater sciatic notch. Then it courses in the gluteal region to be inserted into the upper border of greater trochanter. Piriformis is the key muscle of gluteal region, as all the structures are related to it. The obturator internus, two gemelli, obturator externus, piriformis are all short lateral rotators of hip joint. The largest gluteal muscle is the gluteus maximus. 3/4 part of it is inserted into iliotibial tract, but the deep part of lower half is inserted into the gluteal tuberosity. This muscle not only acts on the hip joint but also controls the knee joint. The shaft, anterior and lateral surfaces of upper 3/4 of shaft, give origin to vastus intermedius. Vastus means large. This is a component of quadriceps femoris muscle. Upper part of anterior intertrochanteric line, root of greater trochanter, and upper half of lateral lip of linea aspera give origin to vastus lateralis, another component of the four-headed quadriceps femoris muscle. Lower part of anterior intertrochanteric line, its continuity, the spiral line, and 3/4 of medial lip of linea aspera give attachment to the third component of quadriceps femoris. Vastus medialis origin extends lower than that of vastus lateralis. This has an important bearing on stabilizing the largest sesamoid bone of the body, the patella. The fourth component of quadriceps femoris arises from the hip bone. This four-headed muscle, quadriceps, marches towards patella to finally reach the tibial tuberosity. It is the chief extensor of the complex joint, the knee joint, and has a great role in transporting one from place to place. Between the origins of vastus medialis and vastus lateralis, from the respective lips of linea aspera are the insertions of pectineus and adductor longus in one line, adductor brevis a little lateral to it, adductor magnus at still more laterally. Adductor magnus muscle descends down towards medial side. This is the insertion of adductor part of adductor magnus. The ischial part of composite adductor magnus gets inserted into the adductor tubercle, leaving an opening for welcoming the femoral artery and vein into the popliteal region. The short head of biceps femoris also arises from linea aspera lateral to adductor magnus. This is the only part of hamstring muscle arising from femur. Others all arise from different parts of ischial tuberosity. The lower end of the lateral supracondylar line gives attachment to plantaris. It comprises a belly of 5 cm and a tendon of about 20 cm. Below plantaris is the origin of lateral head of gastrocnemius. On the medial side is the origin of the medial head of gastrocnemius muscle. Popliteus arises from deep anterior part of the groove on the lateral surface of lateral condyle. It is the key of the locked knee joint. Medial epicondyle on the medial surface of the condyle gives attachment to tibial collateral ligament, forming the medial ligament of knee joint, the joint with the maximum bursae around. On the lateral surface of lateral condyle is the epicondyle, which gives attachment to fibular collateral ligament. This ligament extends from lower end of femur to upper end of fibula. Medial surface of lateral condyle forms the lateral aspect of the intercondylar notch. Attached to this surface is the anterior cruciate ligament from the upper surface of tibia. The lateral surface of medial condyle. Lateral surface of medial condyle forms the medial wall of the intercondylar notch and gives attachment to posterior cruciate ligament from tibia. The cruciate ligament acts as a firm bond of union between the two giant bones of the body, that is femur and tibia. These cross each other like a letter X and hence are called the cruciate ligaments. Popliteal surface is the fourth smooth surface on lower one-third of femur and makes the popliteal vessels comfortable with cushion of fat. On the medial side is the origin of medial head of gastrocnemius. Two head of gastrocnemius and plantaris arise from femur. The thickest component, the soleus, arises from tibia and fibula. These four muscles join in the upper part of calf region and give the leg a smooth, soft and sexy look. In the middle of leg, the tendon issues from it and is called tendocalcaneus. This dissected specimen shows the insertion of the strongest tendon of the body, the tendocalcaneus, into the posterior surface of the calcanean bone.